translation, when all these elements were unmixed, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the origin of creation, along with time, work and the qualities of the modes of material nature, entered into the universe with a total material energy in 7 divisions. Over. After stating the generation of the causes, Kapila Dev speaks about the generation of the effects. At that time, when the causes were unmixed, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in his feature of Garbhodakshay Vishnu, entered within each universe. Accompanying him were all the 7 primary elements, the 5 material elements, the total energy, Mahatattva, and the false ego. This entrance of the Supreme Personality of Godhead involves his entering even the atoms of the material world. This is confirmed in the Brahma Samhita 535. Andantrastha Paramani Chayantrastham. He is not only within the universe but within the atoms also. He is within the heart of every living entity. Garbhodakshay Vishnu, the Supreme Person of Godhead, entered into everything. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta book. How many of us have heard about Dashavatara? Dashavatar. Dashavatar of Vishnu. Okay, let's count the Dashavataras one by one. First avatar, Matsya. Second, Kurma. Okay, we may not be exactly following the order, but let's count 10. At least we'll get 10 marks. Okay, third, Varaha. Fourth, Vamana. Fifth, Narsimhavatar. Sixth, Parshuram. Seventh, Rama. Eighth, Krishna. Okay. Ninth, Balram or Buddha. Not clear. Okay, and 10th. So then comes the main question. Is Krishna avatar of Vishnu or Vishnu is avatar of Krishna? Vishnu is avatar of Krishna. Abhi to aapne kuch aur bola. Vishnu ke 10 avatar hain, usme Krishna bhi ek hai, Balram ji bhi ek hai. How many of us say Krishna is avatar of Vishnu? How many of us say Vishnu is avatar of Krishna? How many of us say humko kya lena dena? Jo bhi kiske avatar? Aap raho jo bhi hai, humko apni zindagi se matlab hai. So how many of us say, okay, we have covered Krishna avatar of Vishnu, Vishnu avatar of Krishna. So let's understand who is Vishnu and who is Krishna. How many of us have gone to a court room, court hall, high court, trial court, anyone? Those who are lucky have not gone so far. Court, court hall, kachari. Am I pronouncing correctly? Court? So, if you see in a court hall, the judge is seated in a very elevated platform. The seat is much higher than the other seats in the hall. And he is respected a lot. When the advocates present a case, what word they use before they start? Your Lord. My Lord. Even if there is a senior advocate, it's a protocol, you have to say, My Lord. And then imagine this person is entering the court hall. There is commotion, people are seated there and all those things. Suddenly everyone gets up. And there is an element of silence. And this judge then goes and sits in his chair. As soon as he sits, everyone sits. And then when there is some commotion, it says, order, order, order. His word is respected. Be disciplined. His word is respected. And then there's a lot of arguments, a lot of discussions between the various advocates. They're putting forth this thing. And then at the end, when he pronounces judgment, everyone has to abide by it. They can appeal to a higher court, but then his word is respected. Then when he walks out of his court hall, if he's passing through that, you know, some balcony or whatever this thing is, people who are talking, people who are otherwise standing there, hush, judge is coming. It can be typical anybody, could be director in an institute, could be some very high MD of a company. And then there is a official car, a driver is there. Moment he approaches the car, the door opens and then he sits in the car. And the car may have a red light. It shows that he is not an ordinary person. So in other words, the sum and substance of what I am saying is he is respected a lot. He is a very exalted person, very powerful person. The same judge, when he comes back home, gets out of this batti wali car, his wife is standing at the door. Does she respect him? He may even complain, kya har roj aap late aate, kya hai sab? Bachcho ko padhana nahi hai kya aapko? Unki koi wo nahi hai. Nahi. And then he enters the hall. And then, you know, he has a grandson. And then grandson, daddu, kya plate hai? Chalo, ghoda bano. And this respected judge, who is also a daddu, becomes a ghoda. And this grandson, he just jumps on, sits on his back and says, chal mere ghode, typically what we have done in the childhood. Now, is it a different person in the court hall and in the house? Yes, no. Is it a different person? Same person or a different person? Same person. But why is he treated differently? In the hall, in the court hall, even elders to him, there could be some advocates who are senior to him in age, they say, my lord. As a protocol, they stand up when he enters. But in the house, he is treated completely different. Why? So in the court hall, there is a relationship between, we all have relationship. The relationship varies. It could be very close relationship. It could be just that I know someone. Right? In one sense, we all are related to each other. There is some relationship. So in the court hall, there is a relation. The relation is, he's an advocate, he's a judge. It could be some colleagues, it could be peers, it could be subordinates. And then because he's in a very exalted position, everyone respects. Because of the power, because of the position, everyone respects that person. So there's an awe and reverence. The same person, when he comes back home, there are another set of people who have another kind of relationship with that same person. And that relationship is very intimate, very close. Like Dadu, he's a grandson, like wife. 40 years, 50 years they have stayed together. So because of that close relationship, that awe and reverence is kept aside. To the extent that a person says, why? How it happened? So in other words, the more intimate the relationship, more element of awe, reverence, this thing is, liberty is taken in that aspect. So ultimately God is one. God is not many. The definition of God is Supreme Personality of Godhead, the cause of all causes. Sarva karana karanam. When there was nothing, he was there. Everything came from him. So the same Supreme Lord, who is the creator, the maintainer, the annihilator, the cause of all causes, supremely powerful, in his form of Vishnu, he is worshipped and respected in awe and reverence. How many of us gone to Tirupati Balaji, Tirupati temple? People stand in queue for 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. And we eagerly wait for darshan. And the darshan will be for how many hours? How many hours you get darshan?
Few seconds.
And everyone. Police or the people are saying, get out, and what are we watching? That here the Lord decked with all the jewels, that karita, that diamond necklace. He is being worshipped in awe and reverence. Right? People go and stand in queue. And he is the best of jewelry, the best of ornaments, the best of dresses, because he is the Lord. So this is equivalent to worship of the Lord as the same Supreme Lord as Vishnu is comparable to in the analogy, in the example we took of a judge in the courtroom. Now same judge when he comes home, now let's bring that Balaji back to relationship with his intimate devotees. What happens? He exchanges very intimate relationship with his close confidants, and that is what Krishna exhibited in Vrindavan. His cowherd boys, they are chastising Krishna, mother is beating Krishna. Because he stole the butter, mother wants to punish Krishna and he is running, and mother is trying to catch hold of Krishna and binds Krishna. The same Lord with his intimate devotees is exchanging a different rasa or a relationship, where just for the reason of that relationship, that understanding that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead is forgotten. Otherwise that rasa will not be very perfect. So Mother Yashoda does not know that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. When Krishna ate that mati, he says, mati khaya kya? Chal mukh khol. And when he saw that whole entire universe is there in the mouth. So Mother is oblivious of the fact that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. But when Krishna wanted to show, he showed the universal form. Showed the form, the entire universe is coming from him. So in other words, Vishnu, Krishna, Narayana, they are not different personalities. Just like the judge in the court hall and the judge in the house are not two different persons, although they are treated differently. So this category of the Lord and his immediate expansions for various purposes, they all are called Vishnu Tattva. Vishnu, Narayana, Krishna, Rama, Keshava, Keshavadhrita, Narhari Rupa, Jai Jagadisha Hare. Prahlad Maharaj was a devotee of Krishna. When Hiranyakashipu got the boon that I should not die in day or night, on land or on water. He took the boon from Brahma. Then same Keshava, the same Lord, Keshava Dhrita Narahari Rupa. He took that form to keep intact all the promises which was made to him and still kill him. Keshava Dhrita Meena Sharira Jai Jagadisha Hari. Is that clear? So that way, these all avataras, in fact, it is not that there are only 10 avataras. Bhagavatam lists even more, 21 avatars, and then he says these are all like, just like in an ocean, there are multiple waves. You cannot count the number of waves. That many avatars and expansions of the Lord are there. These are all, you know, some prominent avatars. That does not mean only 10 avatars are there. There is Shakti Osha avatara, there is different kinds of Leela avataras. Different kinds of avataras are there. So, is that clear to everyone? So, Krishna, Narayana, Vishnu, they all are same personality. And they all come in the category of Vishnu Tattva. Now, Brahma, how does creation came about? What is this creation, different universes and all that? So it is said that the first expansion of the Lord is Karunakshaya Vishnu. In fact, there is Chaturvyuha expansion without getting into the details. Karunakshaya Vishnu, that Vishnu, when he breathes out, innumerable universes are exhaled from his nostrils. And when he inhales, all the universes go in. Which Vishnu is this? Karunakshaya Vishnu. In each of the universe which is created, the same Lord enters as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. In that universe, there is an ocean of water, Garbha. And the Lord lies in that Garbha ocean. And that Vishnu form is called Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And there is another expansion of Lord which is called Shirodakshaya Vishnu, wherein the Lord expands and is present in each and every atom in that universe, including the hearts of the living entity. So the Paramatma which is there, the Lord, is which Vishnu? Shirodakshaya Vishnu. So, Brahma Samhita, Lord Brahma, who is the first created being, what is the duration of this universe? How long the universe lasts? Anyone? How many years? 100 years of? Each universe which is coming out of the breathing of Mahavishnu, and then he inhales, exhale and inhale. That in that universe, the first created being is Brahma, and the duration which the universe remains is lifetime of Brahma. And Brahma lives for 100 years. And each day of Brahma, what's the duration? Thousand Mahayugas. What is one Mahayuga? One cycle of four Yugas. Kali Yuga, what is the duration? 4,32,000 years. What is the duration of Dwapara Yuga? 8,64,000. Like that's 12,00,000 and then 16,00,000 or 17,00,000. These four combination is one Mahayuga. Thousand cycles of such yugas is one day of Brahma. Likewise is one night of Brahma. Some of you must be wondering, abhi tak to theek bol rahe the sab kuch. Kuch sense aa raha tha. Abhi tak jo bola ho to thoda sa lag raha tha ke kuch akal ki baat kar rahe hain. It looks very weird. We are students of science. What? 4,32,000 years, 8,64,000 years, as a 1,000 cycles, as a 100 years, and that is the duration of universe. Universe came and was inhaled by Mahavishnu, and this is the duration. Stephen Hawking, just before he left, few months before, he talked about a parallel universe. Have you heard of this? All along we were thinking that, you know, through the Hubble telescope we have watched this universe. It's huge, so many galaxies, and it's ever expanding. So we all thought that this is the entire universe. So he is talking about a parallel universe. So in other words, we are like a small frog in a well. What we know about this creation, even according to science, there are billions of galaxies, each of them having millions of stars, each of them having its own family of planets. So we are a small speck in the entire creation, and we are talking about the Lord who has created the entire universe. So from Bhagavatam, from Bhagavad Gita, from our Vedic literatures, we come to know that the Supreme Lord Krishna, he has multiple expansions, different Vishnu avatars. This universe comes about, and then he has different expansions in the form of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, Shirodakshaya Vishnu, and he is present also as Paramatma in the heart of all living entities. Anyone has any question based on what we have discussed so far? Anything you would like to ask or clarify? Aage bade? Yes. 1 year of Brahma is 365 days. Yeah. Yeah. And like that there are 100 years of Brahma. See, even in this world we see relative time. There are some animals who live whose life is 5 years, 8 years. Dogs, generally what is the life? 12 to 15 years. I know a person, you know, they're very attached to their pet dog and is not keeping good health. He may leave the body anytime. He's 11 years. Cows, you know, we have a goshala. In 1 year's time, you know, the this thing, how long it takes for the calf to stand and start walking? 2-3 hours. Hamare child, human, this thing, it takes a couple of years. 10 months. Okay. So there's a time difference. A cow who has taken birth can start giving birth to a calf. How many years? 2-3 years. Whereas adolescence, puberty, it's 12 years. A human being lives for about 100 years. So there are some animals, life cycle is 20 years, 30 years. So likewise, Brahma compared to ours is huge. There's some insects where it is few days. As some microbes, it's few hours or few minutes. So likewise, in this creation we see different lifespans. It varies from living entity to living entity. Likewise, Brahma was the first created being, he has the highest. His lifespan is the duration of the universe. Is that clear? So now, so the universes come about. In that universe the Lord is present as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and from Garbhodakshaya Vishnu comes Lord Brahma, who is also called the secondary creator. Who is the primary creator? Vishnu, Lord. And then we have secondary creator. You know, creator, maintainer and destroyer. Who is the creator? We say Brahma. He is the secondary creator. Who is the maintainer? Vishnu. And who is annihilator? Shiva. So this is an overall understanding of this creation. So Brahma Samhita, Lord Brahma, in his prayers he mentions, just like you have one candle, and from that one candle you light many, many candles, and when you light many candles, each of them illuminate or burn with the same intensity. Then you cannot say which is the first candle, which is the second candle, which is the third candle. All of them burn with equal intensity. So likewise, different Vishnu avataras, they all are coming from Lord Krishna. They all are powerful, yet Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. Is that clear? Sarva Karana Karanam. And this is not the verdict of Brahma. Even Vedavyas. Vedavyas, who is Vedavyas? All the Vedic literatures were compiled by Vedavyas. Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Puranas, Itihasas. And the final work of Vedavyas, what is the final work of Vedavyas? Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. In the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam, he talks about different incarnations. Iti chamsa kala pumsa krishnastu bhagavan swayam. And then after explaining that, throughout the Bhagavatam, there's description about the Lord Krishna, who he is, what is his greatness, who this personality is. And finally, in the 10th canto, complete description about Lord and his various intimate pastimes with the devotees is mentioned. When we have a complete understanding of Krishna, then in the 10th canto, when we hear about Krishna dancing with the gopis or doing Ras Leela, all that, we will not misunderstand him. Then we understand that he is not an ordinary personality. He is not like one of us, with lusty desires. Right? So therefore, many times we can get misled. A lot of people, when we say, हाँ सब तो ठीक है लेकिन भगवान ने ऐसा क्यों किया, वो क्यों नाचे, क्यों गोपियों के साथ उन्होंने ये किया. बिकॉज वेन वी डोंट हैव अ कम्प्लीट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अ थिंग, डेफिनेटली वी आर गोइंग टू विद अ लिमिटेड अंडरस्टैंडिंग मिसअंडरस्टैंड ऑल दिस एक्टिविटीज. सो आचार्यस हैव वॉर्न्ड दैट इफ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड स्पेशली अबाउट कृष्णा एंड हिज इंटीमेट पास्टाइम विद द गोपीज, देन वी शुड नॉट जंप इनटू इट डायरेक्टली. It is there in the 10th canto of Bhagavatam. First 9 cantos is systematic explaining who the Lord is, what his various pastimes are, how he is the creator, how he is the maintainer. The entire understanding is explained. Then here it says that the Lord enters in all the universes as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. I'll just read the verse. Accompanying him were all the 7 primary elements, the 5 material elements. What are the 5 material elements? Earth, air, water, fire, ether. The total energy, Mahatattva, and the false ego. It is said for this creation, the root cause of this creation is false ego. I think I have shared this earlier. What is ego? Ego. Ego means identity. Who I think I am. What is false ego? False identity. I am the body. I am the enjoyer. I am the master. So when this false ego arises, then we are in this material world. This material creation. When our real ego develops, then we go back to the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, everyone has ego. Yes or no? I ask again this question. In the spiritual world, everyone has an ego. Yes or no? We hear this word, you should not be very egoistic. In the spiritual world, people have ego. Yes or no?
Yes.
Somebody is saying no. No? They don't have ego? Spiritual ego. Ego means identity. In the spiritual world also people have ego, but real ego. I am Amsha of the Lord. I am servant of the Lord. In the material world, we have false ego. I am not servant of the Lord. I am the Lord. I am not the soul. I am the body. So why we are entangled in this material world? It's because of false ego. Purification of consciousness means dissipating this false ego and awakening our real ego. This material world is compared to a prison house. Just like in a prison house, the prisoners are bound, they are imprisoned and they are tied with some kind of chains. In this material world also, rebellious souls are bound or entangled using what? Today I am going to share with you something very, very important. Can anyone tell me why this material world is compared to a prison house? Let's not understand many things, but let's understand something very deeply and correctly. This material world where we all are living is compared to a prison house. One by one. Raise your hands. Why it is considered a prison house? Yes, Sunil. Illusion of a? So it is not a real jail, it is illusion of a jail. Okay, so jail also is illusion. Yes, why is this world compared to a jail? So why it is jail? Why it's called jail?
Because we have to suffer the consequences.
We can enjoy the consequences also.
Every action has its own consequences.
But good reactions also are there. Good reactions also is there. Not everywhere you can suffer. You have to. You can enjoy also. Sends into a prison house. My question is, why this world is compared to a prison house? How it is similar to a prison house? So in prison house, let's slowly understand this concept. In the prison house, is it designed to be a very comfortable place where prisoners can enjoy life, can be very happy and, you know, mujhe to aur rehna hai yahan pe? Or is it designed where a lot of restrictions, a lot of rules are imposed and life is not so comfortable? Lalu Prasad ji can tell us, not as comfortable as it was outside, isn't it? Malika kaam. And generally when any of this personality, Salman Khan ji was there for 2 days, so the entire media was, kya kar rahe hai wo, kaise so rahe hai, kya khane ko mil raha hai. It is not You can't choose the food you want to eat. And if at all you get something, then it becomes a news. Why partial treatment? Why VIP treatment? It is not designed to be like that. If you want to, you are in a prison house, you want to speak to your family members, there is some time restriction. You want to meet people, only once a week, visitors are allowed. You want to eat something, no. Two chapatis, dal and this thing, it's fixed. You cannot eat whatever you want to eat. You want to, it's quite hot, I want AC, no. The prison laws, based on the kind of imprisonment, you have restrictions. So in other words, you don't get what you demand or what you wish should happen. Things don't go according to your wish. Yes or no? Likewise, let's quickly analyze. In this world also, things don't go as per our wish. Just 2 days back, one very prominent lady expired. Can anyone tell me the name? I'll give you a clue. She was 92 years old. I'll give another clue. She was the wife of the president, Barbara Bush. She was 92 years old. She was wife of one president and she was mother of another president, and she was in White House for 15 years. The best of doctors, the best of treatments were accessible to us. She died. Does that Bush family want her to leave? No. Do they have a choice? No. She was very old. Does she want to get old? Does her family members want her to get old? No. These are not like ordinary persons. You know, sometimes we cannot afford some treatment. These are people who can, the best of doctors of the world can be flown in. They don't have to go to the hospital. The hospitals can be created in their house. So much against our wish, we cannot avoid old age. Much against our wish, we cannot avoid death. Just like in a prison house, life doesn't go as per your wish. You want more varieties of food, but this is what it is served. This is what the prison says. In other words, there are restrictions imposed. Likewise, this material world, Krishna says, it's dukh alayam ashashvatam. It's a place of misery. Again, this is not to be pessimistic, but intrinsically, that's the quality of this place. Dukhalayam ashashvatam. So we said that just like in a prison house, miseries are imposed upon the prisoner so that the prisoner gets reformed and comes out of the prison house as a reformed individual. Likewise, this creation of the Lord is made where, in one sense, the souls who have rebelled against the Lord, who don't want to be the servant of the Lord, who want to be the Lord, who want to be the enjoyer, who want to be glorified rather than glorifying the Lord, are put in this world, are, it's a prison house where different kinds of punishments are given so that a person gets reformed and come out of the material. So this material world, in line with just last time we were discussing, this is not meant where we can know all the laws correctly and settle down peacefully. Like we were talking about how we don't know the correlation between the actions we perform and the enjoyment or suffering. The idea is not to be very wise, understand how the law is working and settle down in this world. The idea of a prison house is not for a person to settle down peacefully in this world, peacefully in the prison house. It is designed to reform a person. and come out of the prison house. Is that clear? Now, in a prison house, a prisoner is held captive. Maybe suppose he is a common room, maybe through some kind of a chain, he is bound. What is the chain which is binding us in this material world? Three modes of material nature, senses. Anybody else? Attachment. So we first said it is the false ego. False ego that I am the enjoyer, I am not the servant, I am the master, I am the Lord. Because of which we have come in this world, and which is compared to like a prison house. Now in a prison house, the prisoners are kept bound, kept entangled, kept captive. What is keeping us captive in this material world? What is keeping us bound? Karma. Anybody else? Attachment. Attachment with what? Ashok. What? You're right. What is the cause of false ego? How the desires are born. So Bhagavatam gives the answer. What binds, what keeps the living entity entangled in this material? Pumsa. Pumsa means man. Striya. Striya means woman. Pumsa striya mithuni bhavam. Mithuni bhavam means, mithun means attraction. Bhava means that feeling. Etam means this. Pumsa striya mithuni bhavam etam tayo mitho hride granthim ahuhu. Even in Christian Bible they talk about Adam and Eve. Then they ate the forbidden fruit, and that's how the creation came about. So pumsa striya mithuni bhavam etam tayo mitho hride granthim. When they come together in the spirit of enjoyment with lusty desires, tayo mitho hride granthim, there's a hard knot tight between these individuals. Hride granthim, I cannot live without you. Hride granthim ahuhu atha. After that, what happens? Graha. One wants a house, kshetra, land, suta, children, apta, relatives, janasya mohoyam, and in this moha, maya moha, aham mameti, I and mine, one gets entangled. The spirit of enjoyment, how does it manifest in this material world? Through attraction. I want to enjoy the opposite. That I want to hear, I love you. It's so pleasing. Somebody loves me. The feeling I get is that of Lord. I am the center of attraction for somebody. That person is incomplete because of me. And we have come to enjoy that feeling. Pumsa striya mithuni bhavam etam tayo mritho hride granthim ahuhu. Hride granthim, this hard knot. And atha, after that what happens? Griha, I want a house. Kshetra, on land, Suta, children, Apta, relatives, friend circle, social circle, and to maintain that, we get busy with plethora of activities. Sheta, Suta, Apta, Vitir, Janasya, Mohoyam, and caught in Mohomaya, Aham, Mameti, I start thinking because of false ego, Aham, Mameti, I and mine. My house, my wife, my children, my family, my property, my land. Actually, nothing is mine. Moh Maya ke jaal mein phase hue hain. So all starting point is that we want to enjoy. The principal enjoyment is what? Attraction to the opposite. And when we want that enjoyment, we pursue that enjoyment, then it has a ramification. It comes with bondage, with a granthi, strong attachment. And then we want, it has graha, kshetra, sute, apta, vite, and then one gets entangled sequentially. Any questions on this? So that's why when we have to get disentangled, it starts with the opposite thing. That's why some element of renunciation, vairagya, detachment, control of desires, control of sexual impulses, practice of celibacy, these all are part of this whole thing. Is that clear? Yes, Sunil? Yes. So there are five principal rasas or relationships. Any relationship what we have in this material world or anywhere can be broadly classified in five divisions. What are the five divisions? One is Shantarasa. We have a relationship with the Prime Minister of the country, Narendra Modi. Yes or no? We have a relationship. What is that relationship? Is he my father? What relationship is that? It's Shantarasa. He is my PM. Right? Shantarasa. Then there's another rasa called Dasya rasa. Dasya means as servitude. Give me example of that. For example, somebody working in the office, he is in one sense serving the boss, serving the company. Then there is Sakya rasa. Sakya means friendship. So we have colleagues, we have friends, we exchange some relationship, that's Sakya. And then we have Vatsalya rasa, which is parental love with our fathers, mother. And then there is Madhurya rasa. Madhurya rasa means conjugal love. In the spiritual world, Madhurya rasa is the highest, because that rasa is devoid of lust. What is the difference between love and lust? Although love and lust looks alike, just like gold and iron, they both are metal, but one is gold, one is iron. Likewise, real love, which is there in Madhurya rasa, is pure love, perverted reflection. This material world is a reflection of what is there in the spiritual world. All these rasas are there, but in a perverted form. The highest rasa in the spiritual world in a perverted form is illicit sex in this material world. So when we talk about Krishna and gopis, why Krishna dances with the gopis? Because in this material world, illicit sex, which is illicit relationship with the woman, extramarital woman relationship, which is full of lust, is very abominable. But in its pure form, devoid of lust, where a person has completely surrendered and given himself to the object of love, is called the Madhurya rasa in the spiritual world. Any other question? We'll go together once. Tirth Yatra. I'm not very sure about where it is. It's there somewhere. Any other question? It's 9 o'clock. So is that clear? This world is compared to a prison house. Why we came? Icha dvesha samuthena dvanda mohena ba. Icha, when we have a desire to enjoy. Dvesha, envy, we want to be the Lord. And when we come in this material world, how does this icha come prominently? You can renounce wealth, you can renounce everything, but attraction to, for enjoying the opposite sex, Prabhupada says, hippies, they have given up their parents, given up family, given up wealth, but they cannot give up this. That icha, the desire, that for that person I become the center of attraction. I want to enjoy. All are jivas meant to give pleasure to the Lord. But when I want to be the center of attraction, when I want to be the enjoyer, when I want to enjoy that rasa, which is stemming from dvesha, envy, which in the material world, the Lord, see how beautifully the Lord has done. Think about it. Intrinsically, everyone is made of flesh, bone, mucus, urine, stool, isn't it? Intrinsically. But we see this 8-month-old, 10-month-old person getting raped. What is that attraction? The person helplessly breaks all laws. What is that? Who has made that arrangement? The living entity has to desire, and the Lord has created a form. This is the meaning of Maya. And we get helplessly attracted. We want to enjoy. Okay, enjoy. It comes with a series, a package. It's a package. Okay, enjoy. Atha Shreya Griha Suta Apta Vita Janasya Moha. It comes with Moha. Maya. Aham Mameti. One gets caught, entangled in I and mine. So this is Moha, I and mine. Mere bachche hai, mere father hai, mera land hai, mera ghar hai. Mera ye hai. In one sense, it's moha. Everything is left behind. This land is not mine. This house is not mine. This property is not mine. This money is not mine. This ability is not mine. I'm just a kshetrajna. That is real ego. I am Amsha of the Lord. Janasya mohoyam aham mameti, I and mine. I get caught in this understanding, this ego of I and mine. That's why jnana and vairagya. Jnana means knowledge and vairagya means detachment. Is that okay, everyone? Wish you all the best. Prabhupada ki, Mantraj Srimad-Bhāgavatam ki.